Learn how to make this fancy handle on this edition of Mike Reed Outdoors.
Hey, good afternoon, you all. God bless all of you. Welcome to Mike Reed Outdoors. Thank you all for watching. In this video, we're going to make a decorative twisted handle for anything that you want. Pokers, little shovel fire handles, all that kind of stuff. Things like you use in around your stove. So what we're going to do, you all, is it's called a wheat twisted handle, or it looks like a piece of wheat. We're going to take some quarter inch stock that I've got right here. That's what I've got it laying around here. And we're going to, this is going to require a little bit of forge welding for you people who, I got a really good deep fire over there for this forge welding. So if you got a gas forge, it's pretty simple in a gas forge, I think, to do this. Just as long as you keep your pieces in the right way, in the right place. But anyway, traditionally, these things are made simply by, the first thing you do is you just like forge weld these pieces together, just like this, okay? Right on the end. You're going to make a pair of these things is what we're going to do, okay? But what I'm going to do, instead of doing it that way, I'm going to bend these in the center, bend them around, forge weld them 2 inches back, and then put the twist in it and forge weld it again, so that when we're done, we're going to have two pieces of twisted metal right here. Now the twists are going to be, one of them is going to be clockwise and one of them is going to be counterclockwise, so that this comes out to look the way we want it to look, okay? So let me get that thing ready to roll right there, and we'll put some bends in these pieces of metal, and then I'll show you what I'm talking about. Alright, now what we'll do is we'll take and make us a mark on it back at 2 inches, and then we will forge weld that part of it right there. That just saves us from having to forge weld it and hold those two pieces together, okay? That way they'll come out equal. On the bottom of that fire right there, you all, I have got just wood charcoal, and hopefully that lets us come out with a really good weld the very first time. Now, you can weld without flux, but I'm not really good at it, so I always just use flux. Pretty good. Looks pretty good. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to make you a pair of them that looks pretty much identical, okay? Just like that right there. Now, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to measure down from the weld to about 5 inches. Okay, put your mark on them. 5 inches. We're going to have to weld down below that, okay? That's what we're going to do now. Uh-huh.
All right, let me weld up the other one, and then I'll bring you back and we'll do the twisting, okay?
So see what we're trying to do? Forge weld here, left open right here, you all.
This one will be clockwise. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Jeez, hard work, you all. Okay, so see what we're doing? Let me straighten that one up right there and I'll come back. All right, you all, what I'm going to do to make sure that these don't slip on me in the fire, I'm going to go around there and take my arc welder and just barely tack the ends of them in place, okay? Just like that right there. Then we'll come back and forge weld them together. Okay, you all, I want to make sure you all see this, you guys who use coal. This right here is really good coke. Now the coal that I'm using right there is soft coal, so it makes really good coke. You can see that I've got my fire way higher than I normally just am if I'm just forging. Okay, you got to have a really deep fire. You want a fire about 8 inches deep when you're forge welding. All right, you all, when you're doing a forge weld like I'm getting ready to do right here, make sure that it sticks the very first time you do it, because if you don't, it's highly likely that it will never stick, okay? So you can tell if it sticks when the next time you go to forge on it, it moves out of shape or comes, you can see where you've welded it, it's come loose. So make sure that when you bring it out of the fire that very first time for that first weld, you just tap it and stick it and go straight back to the fire. Flex it, go straight back to the fire. Now it's stuck. There it comes. All right, you all. At this point, you can make this however you want it to look. If you want to draw it out and put a ring in it to hang it up, you can do that. If you just want to make a decorative turn in it, you can do that as well. Now the next thing we're going to do is we're going to flatten this area right here. Always make sure that you do this first before you forge weld it together down here, you all, okay? If you don't, that thing will bulge out on you. All right, now it's time to forge weld it back here, you all, to whatever length that you want this to be. But we're going to have to close it up from here to wherever we stop at. And I'm going to go down there about 3 inches. Looking pretty good. All right, you all, we're going to put just a slight bend in the end of this. Just to give it just a little bit of shape for your hand, okay? So now what we're going to do is we're going to create the poker.
end of the poker where we're going to weld it on to that handle right there. Now we have to scarf both ends of it so that we can forge weld them together. All right, you all, this project's taking me about 2.5 hours now. I did take it around there and tack that handle in place because I'm just a little bit short right there when I run my... That's the problem with little bitty short forges. I'm a little bit short on being able to run that thing all the way through, you know, where I need it to go. So I tacked it in place and then now we're going to forge weld it and dress that joint up. We'll let that end of it cool now. Since that's finished, we'll just put us a nice coat of oil on that end of it. You all, here is our finished. It's still hot on the end. There is our finished fireplace poker. Okay. This just takes practice. I am not the world's best at this, you all. But if you don't practice it, you never learn how to do it. Okay. Later on, I'll weld a spur on that thing. Anyway, you all, thanks for watching this video. God bless you. Have yourself a wonderful day.